Chicago.
Plus, Denise Robertson opens her heart about her...
It's Eating Disorders Week, and... Marti Pellow joins us live in just a few moments. First, it's your last chance to get involved in today's competition. Pick a pair.
Two, well, personal demons, shall we say.
His life is now back in control, and though he says it's still a daily battle, he's relishing the rave reviews of his performance as Billy Flynn in the West End musical Chicago. And at this moment, they are screwing in the bulbs to put his name up in lights on Broadway. But first, remember this.
I feel it in my finger. I feel it in my toe. Love is all around me, and so the feeling grows.
And here he is. He says he's the like the kid in the candy shop at the moment.
Oh, absolutely.
Are you having? You must. You sound like you're having a ball.
Well, for me, this, you know, to get asked to do Chicago in the West End was a big thing for me, you know. And funny enough, call it mother's intuition or whatever, my mother said to me, oh, I'll be Broadway next, son. You know, and I thought, wow. you're having me on. And rightly enough, that's the way it ended up. They offered
Incredible.
Me
Incredible. So the Hollywood, the Broadway producers...
Oh, that'll be next, Hollywood.
Hollywood,
next.
Oh, yes,
oh, come
definitely.
On, stop.
So the Broadway producers turned up in London to see you as Billy Flynn. I thought, this is the guy we want.
Absolutely. They must have enjoyed my performance. I mean, I had such a great time there because I'd never done anything like this before, so the fear of the unknown and such like, you think, well, you know, can I pull this off? But with the right help, you know, and the good people that were involved in the production of Chicago, you know, really pointed me in the right direction, and I was really open to the process, you know, and I really became excited about it because I thought my only passion would always lie in songwriting and that field where I'm very familiar and very comfortable at. But I found a window of time where I could, you know, have that wee challenge, and it seemed to all make sense.
But is it hugely different to I mean, you perform in front of so many people, so many times as a band. Mm-hmm. Was it so different, your opening night in the theatre? Is it because there was a lot riding on it that it was so scary?
It's that fear of the unknown, and, you know, will I be able to pull this off, or, you know, am I in the wrong arena here? Is this, you know, just all the fear of the unknown. But once you go on, and, you know, I'd really worked hard at it to achieve it, then I managed to pull it off, and then you get into it, and away you go.
Yes.
It's fantastic.
And then when you get to Broadway, I mean, how well are Wet, Wet, Wet known in America?
We did OK in the States, you know. I mean, to be perfectly honest, I was more nervous doing my opening night in Chicago in the West End than I was playing Madison Square Gardens.
Really?
You know, because that was our show. So when you go in there in that environment, it's like, you know, it's my show, and if I want to stop the band, and then that's it. But in this, you're kind of... But what's exciting, and what I really enjoy about Chicago is being part of a team again. You know, in that whole, when you get a good cast and a great set, everybody supports everybody, and there's some... The discipline about it as well, I find really comforting, knowing where you're going to be every night. And it's just... And if it's a good cast, which lucky enough, I have on the West End was great, and I've met some of the cast that I'm going to be working with on the tour, which opens in Manchester as well.
Yes.
So I'm doing Manchester, and then I'm going to Broadway, and I'm really looking forward to working with a new.
I'm going to Manchester. I'm doing Broadway.
I'm doing Broadway, lad, and then from Broadway, Dublin, straight to Tokyo. No, I've got Liverpool.
Well,
you can't, you know, go to Liverpool.
Lucky old people in Manchester. I think you open on, when is it, 1st of March? No, 17th of February, and you play until the 1st of March in Manchester.
Mm-hmm.
And then straight over to Broadway with the same cast, the Manchester cast.
No, so that I'm doing the Broadway cast there.
So are you taking anyone over from here, or is it it's an all-American cast? Is it?
No, just me and my sense of humour.
Is that right?
Yeah. And hopefully, as you can tell by my dulcet tones, I'm not, you know, I don't come from Chicago, so it should be fun and games over there.
And have you seen the movie?
Yes, I've seen it. I'm a fan of it. You know, I love the whole story, and I love the performances that Richard and Rennie, and, you know, the whole lot is just a great package. It's so entertaining and so accessible. You know, it's not like a hard work musical, and the TV and the movie interpretation is phenomenal too. And I love Fosse's choreography. And, well, the interpretation they do of it in the movie is fantastic.
Well, we're going to see you do a little bit of the old singing and dancing later on.
Well, yes, I'll put one foot in front of the other.
Yes,
I can do that
with the girls. And
what about music? Are you? I mean, you've got.
I just released an album at Christmas of the old Wet, Wet, Wet stuff. You know, these are some of the favourite songs, and some of the songs that I just wanted to revisit over the last couple of decades, you know, and have another wee play around with them, and it turned out well, and it's doing great.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got it.
I think that's how they do it.
That's very well done.
That's really the way. There you go. Perfect.
Because it's you singing wet, wet, wet. It's you singing wet, wet, wet. It's not you with the band.
No, it's me. I just, you know, I've taken these songs on the road and I changed them and put a little bit more of my identity onto them. Not to say that the songs were ever broke anyway, because Wet, Wet, Wet were a great time in my life. I thoroughly enjoyed it and still do.
Yeah.
Two very distinct paths opened up to you now. There is that theatrical path and that musical path. I mean, do you know where you're going to be concentrating?
I think it's like, you know, to be an eclectic entertainer is brilliant. You know, to have the luxury of being able to go into both environments, it just makes me grow as an individual also. You know, to have the luxury of being able to do that and to embrace them. Mm. You know, it's great, it's exciting.
Well, now, we were reading at the weekend and sometime like that you're going into Chicago. Apparently, you're leaving here.
Why, I yada.
TV host joining the musical Chicago is the next Billy Flynn, the sleazy lawyer, now played by EastEnder Michael Greco.
Yeah.
So, is it true?
Who can say? No, I was asked. I was asked.
It's a great part.
It is a fantastic part, and it was very, very tempting. But I'm going to concentrate on the telly for a little while. Is that all right?
You wanted to be here instead?
I said I'll stay here. For the time being.
Bless his heart.
He's a good egg. You're a good egg.
Look, when he leaves Broadway, do you want to nick
I'll do that
one. Oh, you're doing the Broadway?
Yeah.
Okay,
slightly, well. Need slightly more bulbs. You see, that's why I've never asked.
It's the bulb
my
thing.
Name. My name's too long.
M-A-R-T-I-P-E-L-L-O-W. That's 11.
P-H-I-L-L-I-P-S-C-H-O-F.
Yeah, they can't afford it.
Goes on forever.
Well, let's just go all the way right down Broadway.
Listen, have the best time.
Well, thank you very much.
I really just
yes.
hope
we
it goes
you.
A storm for you. Fabulous.
And you're going to sing live for us today. And
yes,
which number are you going to do for us?
I'm going to do All I Care About Is Love.
Fantastic. Good. Thank you, Marti.
Thank you very
and
much.
Have a wonderful time.
I will.
Good.
Now then, next up, Denise reveals all performance of sleazy lawyer Billy Flynn in Chicago. It seems like a sure bet. So here he is, Marti Pellow with the all-time classic All I Care About Is Love.
I don't care about expensive things, cashmere coats, diamond rings, don't mean a thing. All I care about is love.
That's what I'm here for.
I don't care for wearing silk cravats, ruby studs, satin spats, don't mean a thing. All I care about is love.
All he cares about is love.
Give me two eyes of blue, softly saying,
I need you.
Let me see her standing there and almost Mr. I'm a millionaire. I don't care for any fine attire, Vanderbilts might admire. No, no, not me. All I care about is love.
All he cares about is love.
Maybe you think I'm talking about physical love. Well, I'm not. Not just physical love. There are other kinds of love. Like love of justice, love of legal procedure, love of lending a hand to someone who really needs you, love of your fellow man. That's the kind of love that I'm talking about. And physical love ain't so bad either. It may sound odd, but all I care about is love.
That's what he's here for.
Boo, 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 boo. Honest to God, all I care about is love.
All he cares about is love.
Show me long, long raven hair flowing down about to there. Let me see her running free and keep your money, that's enough for me. I don't care for driving peppered cars or smoking long butt cigars. No, no, not me. All I care about is Dona Gayan, who's picking on you, twisting the wrist that's turning the screw. All I care about is
so funny.
Richie, just watching there, Richie said, and you turn that down, you idiot.
Yeah, what can you say?
Listen, well done, girls,
Broadway
by the way, whatever they've got.
Broadway for a major treat. It's lovely to see Marti Pellow.
Terrific. Have a great time.
Oh, I'm really looking forward to it.
I bet you are.
Fantastic. Good stuff. Fantastic. Good. Thank you.
Right, time for a break now. When we come back, Michael Jackson like you have never, ever seen him before.